Welcome to Mind Your Body. I'm Stephanie Stevens with the colorful and wonderful Lorianne Robinson, image and fashion consultant, veteran of film and television, the bold and the beautiful, Emmy nominated, and today she's here to help us with color.
Thank you for asking me to talk about one of my favorite subjects, Stephanie.
I can tell. In fact, I love what you're wearing. It's appropriate for you, and I'm wondering, how do the rest of us learn to use color that well, correctly?
Color is really important, and wearing your correct colors, especially as we age, is even more critical, because it's going to make you look healthier, more vibrant, sexier.
All good.
And it's really going to help along with that aging process. You're not going to, you know, quite look as old as maybe you feel if you're wearing your correct colors.
How do we learn to use the right colors?
Well, it's based on your natural hair color,
okay,
your eye color, and your skin. Those three things factor into knowing your best colors. You can be either warm or you can be cool. And your skin tones. And warm is usually with a lot of yellow and peach in your skin. And if you're cool, you have a little bit more pink, even some lavender or even blue in your skin. So for instance here, if you're warm skin tone, orange is going to be beautiful on you. Absolutely beautiful. If you're cool skin tone, you might be better off something with more of a blue-based color, say this pinky red.
So these are warm and cool colors.
These are all warm and cool colors. And one of the things, as we age, you might not be able to wear the bright, bright colors you did, say, at 23, 30.
Really?
And, you know, say you are great in red. You love this bright red. This is a very cool red. It's got a lot of blue in it. As you get older, it might be a little harsh on you.
Okay.
So you might want to venture into something a bit softer, saying a red that has more pink in it. It's still cool, but it's a bit softer, and it'd be more flattering for you.
And I know you have talked about the importance of these colors around the face, and I know that you can work some magic with scarves, so
yes,
I hope you'll do that.
Scarves are a wonderful way to not only camouflage our aging necks, which how many women do you know that love their neck? No, we want to cover up our neck. But it also adds in some color that brings that attention up around the face. And one of the easiest things you can do is collect scarves. So say you have a wardrobe built on neutrals, and you know some of these neutrals are not your best. For instance, this on a warm skinned person is not their best colors, black or that stark white. You might want to add something in there that is a little bit more colorful, and that's going to, again, bring that attention around the face and make you look a lot healthier and more alive. And I'm going to show you a little trick. So I took that big square scarf and I tied it in, and I folded it in half. And what I'm going to do now is take a very, very important piece of equipment. It's a tiny little silicone rubber band. Whoops.
Lost one.
Lost one.
We've got another one.
That's why I have two.
You're always prepared.
I'm prepared. I'm a Girl Scout. So you take this little rubber band and you put it into the center of the scarf. And you put two of these center pieces together and you tie that rubber band around. Okay, so you make that tiny little knot. Then you take, like old-fashioned if you were doing bunny ears, and you pull.
Oh, wow.
That scarf, and you can make a beautiful neck bow, and then you can stuff within the collar of that blouse, and you can just add yourself some color that way. And then it just brings a different whole light to your outfit and brings some color up around your face.
Good tips, color and camouflage. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Lorianne.
You're welcome.
That's great advice. And thank you for joining me here on Mind Your Body, where we're good with scarves and we're good with color. I'm Stephanie Stevens.